This week's Celebrity Spotlight is really close to my heart because I've always had a fascination with Maya Angelou, which is that African-American poet, writer, just inspirationalist. She was a unique person, and I'm a people watcher, so I like to watch people, and she was one of the fascinating ones to me. So doing her chart and seeing it in full color, and even when she died, and looking at her purpose and her path was really intriguing to me, because she, like Trump, it was just so interesting because this month has a lot of that going on. She had double fours, which usually is in excess, means that you're seeking instant gratification or you're seeking an abundance of physical stuff, you know, that kind of thing, and being really caught up in like maybe excessive shopping or whatever. But for her, it was really a conduit. It was more like, four is also called the angel number. So it's that energy that allows angels or spirits to permeate the physical, so they say. So they call it the angel number. So she was really like channeling a lot of her, you know, it's like a download almost. You know, sometimes you write something and you're like, wow, did I just write that? That was pretty cool. And it was probably something from somewhere else, the ethers or wherever. So she was, you know, an interesting character. She had not a lot on the mental at all. She really just had the nine. It was really soul-based and physical. So it was about bringing all this passionate stuff that she had in here to fruition through those double fours. And she has a single one, which the balance expression is 2-1. So anything less or anything more is unbalanced. So she wasn't meant to verbally through speaking share her wisdom and knowledge, it was through the writing. And anyone who has a single one has a difficult time expressing that inner self fully through verbal means, whether, unless it's on paper. So it's like, if I ask you, if you had, let's say, 1-1 or 10-1s, how are you feeling, what's really going on? You might not say it all to me verbally, but if I said, write me a letter or write me an email, there's all of you. So that's how she was. It was like she was able to put it on paper. So she also had the arrow of skepticism, which really intrigued me too. So this woman is something. I mean, she was something, she is something, wherever she is now. She was a 10, which is the earth guide that leads through casual conversation. So her work was down to earth grounded. It wasn't airy fairy or, you know, it was really real, raw, authentic, which I loved. So she actually died on a 22-4 cycle, which is the master builder, but it's also foundation shifting. So again, shifting out, you know, she was done what she was here to do. She was actually on her last peak cycle, which was a 6, which is the creative visionary. So she really hit the epitome of what she was here to do. And then she was out. So that's, in its entirety, what happens. I mean, when we're done, we're done. So I want to say happy birthday to Maya Angelou, wherever you are. I hope you're at peace and still writing. And tune in again next week, and we'll have another interesting Celebrity Spotlight here on LotteryUSA.com.